Good afternoon, everyone. We heard in the opening call today, at the beginning of our Mass, this prayer, this request asking the Lord for faith, hope, and charity, which is to say, perfect love. We've asked the Lord to strengthen us with these things, to give these things to us. So what does that mean for us? The blind man in the Gospel is an excellent example that we just heard. He has all of these things, faith, hope, and charity. That is why we heard Jesus say to him, your faith is saved. And so the big question for all of us, is our faith enough to save us? How can our faith save us? Naturally, this includes going to church every Sunday, doing good work, following God's will here on earth. That is part of how we show our faith. And when we think about it, without the church, we wouldn't have those three things. We wouldn't have faith, hope, or charity. Without the church, we would be missing those things. But we do have all those things. We do have faith, hope, or charity to help us face whatever challenges we may encounter along the way. And we can get through and overcome those obstacles together. I remember on April 16th, 2021, I got a text message from the Cardinal asking to see me. And so I said, okay, and I went to meet with Father Bob Blaney, the Cardinal's delegate. He said, I have good news for you. And I said, okay, well, what's that? He said, Cardinal Sean O'Malley wants you to be assigned to St. Jude's Parish in Waltham, to eventually become pastor there. And in that moment, I looked at him and, to be honest with you, I never in a million years thought that that would happen. I didn't think that the diocese was going to offer me that opportunity to be assigned as a pastor. I always doubted that, and you can guess why. It's because I'm deaf. I didn't know if they would believe in me, and I was nervous when I got asked that. You know, and that's a normal thing, right? Everybody has that experience of being nervous. That's what it means to be normal. And so that was my reaction while being excited when I got that assignment. And I've been here now for a little over 3 years, and things have been going along really well. We've been investing in the community, and things have really been beautiful to see the improvements, especially the renovations. We look at the church hall downstairs in the basement and the rectory. It's really starting to feel more like home, and it's looking like it too. I know you've heard me say this in the past, that I have asked everybody to prayerfully consider increasing their offertory on a weekly basis for the benefit of the community. So I thank you for those of you who have done that. And I know that this is a very challenging time that we live in. The economy is difficult for many people with inflation, and there are a lot of economic challenges that we all face as families as well as the church. However, we do need to make sacrifices to make this work. I recently had a meeting with the Archdiocese, and they were happy to see that the weekly offertory had been increasing, but also at the same time, we were still operating with a net loss of 13,000 last month, for example. And so I'm looking at the numbers and analyzing things more and more. It is better compared to when I first was assigned here over 3 years ago. That was a much more significant loss than we were operating at on increase giving, and especially when we first got here and didn't think we could do a lot of renovation. So I was thinking about what to say, and I really don't want to beg. I really don't. But at the same time, I would ask you to prayerfully consider, what can you do to help support the church, to help it work in an ongoing way, an ongoing basis? And if you think about that number, 13,000, as a gap to close, you divide it over the 4 weeks in the month, and each weekend, how much more we need to see coming in, it's about $3,500 a week. So we can continue to work on reducing that net loss without depending on the income from the school, but saving that as needed. Then we can do it. If we take that loss, that operating loss on a monthly basis, and we divide it by the 200 or so families that we have registered in parish off, it really only amounts to a $17 per family increase on a weekly basis. So, anyways, I'm going to type all this information out before I give you the letter and send it up, to have it for you to review and share, but I just wanted to share it with you now. And we will have other things to help raise money for the parish, such as a bazaar or our payment coming up, things that we have that we will be using to build our community as well as increase our financial position. And at the same time, we will be increasing our faith in hope and charity. Remember what my favorite saint, Pope John Paul II, said, be not afraid. God bless you.